My talk today will be about the CT features of small bowel obstruction. CT is more sensitive than radiographs and will demonstrate the cause in more than 80% of cases. Features on CT may include dilated small bowel lobes more than 3 cm from outer wall to outer wall, normal caliber or collapsed distal lobes distally, small bowel feces sign, which is mixture of small bowel contents with the gas, creates an appearance similar to feces in the colon. The main importance of a small bowel feces sign is usually seen just proximal to the transition zone or transition point. Protocol of CT in cases of a small bowel obstruction is CT with intravenous contrast and with no oral contrast. With intravenous contrast, in order to detect the complications of a small bowel obstruction like ischemia or perforation, and no oral contrast because patients with a small bowel obstruction are nauseated and may vomit, potentially leading to aspiration of the gastrographin, which is more dangerous than aspiration of barium, and it can lead to lethal pneumonitis. Also, we shouldn't give oral contrast because in cases of a small bowel obstruction, there will be intraluminal retained small bowel secretions, which is of low attenuation. So it will provide excellent contrast relative to the normally enhancing bowel wall, which is obscured by high attenuation oral contrast material if we give oral contrast. Also, coronal and or sagittal multiplanar reformations have been shown helpful to identify the transition point. So the advantage of CT. Number one, diagnose the obstruction. Number two, detect the level of obstruction. Number three, diagnose the cause of obstruction. Number four, detect the complications of the small bowel obstruction like ischemia or perforation. Number five, it rule out other possible pathologies rather than small bowel obstruction. Now, I will show you some examples of small bowel obstruction by CT scan.
Case number one for a lady, 57 years old, with gynecological surgery many years prior, presented with signs of intestinal obstruction. A CT study was done with intravenous contrast administration and no oral contrast. As you see, the CT study axial images revealed marked dilatation of small bowel lobes, as you see, with its characteristic valvular connivance. The small bowel filled with fluid. The best way to localize the cause of the obstruction and to know the level of obstruction is to start from the distal collapsed small bowel lobes. So we have to trace starting from the region of the cecum. Here, this is the cecum here, which is collapsed, and we have to trace until reaching to the terminal ileum. Here, this is the terminal ileum. Here, going more caudal, we can appreciate more collapsed lobes of a small bowel, as you see here. So we have marked proximal small bowel dilatation. We have collapsed distal small bowel lobe in the distal ileal lobes until reaching to the region of transition or transition zone or transition point, as you see here. This is collapsed distal ileal lobe. This is the zone of transition, and this is the proximal dilatation of the small bowel. No evidence of any soft tissue mass lesion here. So this is a classic picture of fibrous adhesion as a cause of a small intestinal obstruction, as you see here. The next step is to see if there is any complication or no, especially ischemia and pneumoperitoneum, as you see, normal enhancement, normal wall of the small bowel, no evidence of thickening of the wall, no evidence of non-enhancement of the wall to suggest ischemic changes. At the same time, no evidence of pneumoperitoneum could be appreciated. Coronal reconstruction for the same patient revealed marked dilatation of the small bowel lobe, as we see in the axial images. This is the valva connivance, the characteristic mucosal fold of the small bowel. When we go down to the region of the lower abdomen, here we can appreciate the region of transition zone between the normal caliber of the distal ileal lobes, as you see here, this is down here, and the proximal dilated small bowel lobe, as you see here also. So this is the proximal dilated lobe. If you notice also inside the proximal dilated small bowel lobe, we have the small bowel feces sign, which help us in localization of the transition zone, usually located just proximal to the region of the obstruction, as you see. The second case for male patient, 50 years old, requested for CT abdomen to rule out intestinal obstruction. The technique was done with intravenous contrast administration. No oral contrast was given. The axial cuts show, as you see here, marked dilatation of the proximal small bowel lobes. These are the valvular connivance. And as we said before, the best way to diagnose the cause and level of obstruction, we have to go more distal to appreciate the cecum and the collapsed distal ileal lobes. After that, we trace proximally until reaching the transition zone. This is the ascending colon. At the unitis, we have multiple diverticular changes, no evidence of diverticulitis. When we go down, this is the terminal ileum, and the distal ileal lobes collapsed, as you see, collapsed distal ileal lobes, as you see here. So we have proximal dilated lobe, and we have distal collapsed lobe. So we have to trace these collapsed lobe until reaching to the zone of transition. So notice this one here. This is one of the distal ileal lobes. This is proximal dilated one. So here, this is the region of transition here. We have here incarcerated left inguinal hernia, as you see. This is the hernia here. The proximal part showing marked dilatation of the small bowel, and the distal part is collapsed distal ileal lobes. So this is the zone of transition. So the diagnosis is small intestinal obstruction due to incarcerated left inguinal hernia. At the same time, there is no complication like ischemia, because there is normal wall thickening of the bowel, normal enhancement, as well as there is no evidence of any intra-peritoneal free air to suggest the bowel perforation. As you see, what do we see here? This is the large gallbladder stone, but no signs of cholecystitis. This is corona reconstructed images for the same patient, revealed the left inguinal hernia. The incarcerated left inguinal hernia is seen here, with marked proximal dilatation of the small bowel and collapse of the distal lobe. So this is collapse of the distal ileal lobes, and this is marked dilatation of the proximal small bowel lobes with normal wall enhancement and thickening, as we mentioned in the axial cuts. The third case for female patient, 40 years old, complaining also of query intestinal obstruction. CT study done with intravenous contrast administration, and no oral contrast was given. Also, we see marked dilatation of the proximal small bowel lobes with its characteristic valvular connivance, as you see. As we say before, also we have to trace the obstruction from distal to proximal. So starting with the ascending colon until reaching to the region of the cecum and terminal ileum. So this is the cecum, this is the terminal ileum. The terminal ileum and the distal ileal lobes are collapsed, as you see here. And we have proximal dilatation of the small bowel, so we have to trace these collapsed distal ileal lobes in the right lower abdomen, as you see, until reaching to the zone of transition. So this is one of the distal ileal lobe, this is one of the proximal lobe, which is marked dilated. So in this region here, in the right lower abdomen, we can see that this is the transition zone here, located in the right femoral hernia. So this is the cause of obstruction, and here this is the transition zone, dilatation of the proximal small bowel lobe and collapsed distal ileal lobes. So this is another case of a small intestinal obstruction due to femoral hernia on the right side. There is no evidence of any complication, normal enhancement and the thickening of the small bowel to suggest ischemia, and also no evidence of any pneumoperitoneum to suggest bowel perforation. The coronal reconstruction images for the same patient revealed again marked dilatation of a small bowel, fluid filled valvular connivance going to the region of the right femoral hernia, which we appreciated in the axial cuts. This is the right inguinal hernia here, and this is the zone of transition. So this is the proximal dilated small bowel lobe, this is the transition zone, and this is the region of the hernia here, and this is the distal collapsed ileal lobes, as you see here. So these are collapsed ileal lobes, and this is proximal marked dilatation of the small bowel lobes. So this is a case of a small bowel restriction due to right femoral hernia. The last case for male patient, 68 years old, requested for CT abdomen to rule out intestinal obstruction. CT was done with intravenous, and also oral contrast was given, as you see here in the small bowel loops. What do we have? We have also marked dilatation of the small bowel, appreciated by its valva connivance, as we mentioned before. So we have to localize the cause of obstruction and the level of obstruction by tracing the distal collapsed loop starting from the region of the cecum and coming proximally. So this is the ascending colon, so we have to go more distal to the region of the cecum to start from there, going down, down, down. Oh, what do we have? We have soft tissue mass located in the cecum with multiple regional lymph nodes enlargement. This tumor is seen extending to the terminal ileum, as you see here. So we have tumor involving the cecum, and this is the cause of the small intestinal obstruction, as you see here. So this is the diagnosis: cecal tumor causing marked dilatation of the small bowel.
So this is everything related to small bowel obstruction by CT scan. See you inshallah in next capsule with large bowel obstruction. Thank you very much.